Hi everyone, it's Travis here with ProNav Marine. We've got a beautiful day up in the Keweenaw, and we decided this would be a great opportunity to show folks how not to calibrate your ProNav Angler. It's opening weekend here for walleye, pike, across the Midwest. All these species are coming into season. So, of course, this is a really busy time on the water, and everybody's getting out for the first or second time of the year. They're hooking up their ProNav Angler, possibly for the first time ever. And one of the very important things that we want to cover and make sure everybody knows how to do is to properly calibrate the ProNav Angler so that your motor is going to perform as expected when you start fishing those routes and setting up your spread to catch those big walleye. So the first thing I'm going to point out, this video is how not to calibrate your ProNav Angler. We're sitting here at the dock and we've got our ProNav installed on the motor. Everything about the installation is correct for our written documentation, so make sure you reference our installation cards. The first thing you'll notice is I'm sitting on a very large steel dock. We've got heavy steel beams underneath this dock here, and steel is highly magnetic. Now I say that because one of the instruments in the ProNav Angler that helps it navigate your boat for you is a very sensitive flex gate compass, which, you know, if you have this compass next to a large ferrous or magnetic object, such as a steel I-beam, this compass is going to point straight towards the I-beam. That's how a compass operates. So by calibrating this device sitting next to the steel structure, this unit is actually going to get a bad calibration. The reason I know that, which we'll show you in a second, is because once I've completed my calibration and I head out fishing, this motor is not going to head in the direction I'm expecting when I hit the go button in the app. So we'll do a quick calibration here. So I'm coming into the ProNav Angler app, I'm connected up, I'm going to go to the main menu, top left corner, I'm going to hit calibrate, I'm going to follow the instructions on the screen, and hit start. So far, aside from sitting next to a steel structure, I've done everything correctly as far as installing and following the instructions to calibrate the ProNav Angler. However, what we're going to see in a minute is that because of this large interference here, this device is going to basically behave very poorly. So when the device is calibrating, what is doing the GPS and compass living in this upper unit here? The calibration is designed to actually calibrate the device, the ProNav device, to the magnetic field in your area where you fish. So by turning in roughly a 360 degree circle, the compass inside the ProNav unit is hitting at least three cardinal compass directions: north, east, south, west. By hitting those directions, that's how this device knows where it's at relative to the Earth's magnetic field. So that's why we calibrate this unit, and that's why it's very important to do it properly. So as we can see here, I'm going to turn the motor. I'm going to point the motor towards a known landmark. I'm going to point it just straight down this canal that we're sitting on right now. So I'm going to point my motor in a known direction, and I'm going to come into my map view on the app. And in the map view, I can see my boat's location on the screen. That's taking it from GPS, so it's overhead. The boat's showing correctly on the map. And if you look closely at the boat icon on the map screen, you'll notice a green arrow sticking out of the boat. Now my motor is pointing this direction down the canal, and currently the green arrow on my app screen is pointing this way, almost the exact opposite way of the motor's pointing. What should be the case is that the green arrow on your map screen should always be pointing the same direction as the trolling motor, within some small margin of error. You know, typically it's going to be lined up with your trolling motor within 10 degrees to either side of the motor heading, if you have a good calibration. So now that I've got a bad calibration of this unit, if I wanted to anchor my boat right here, so I come into my home screen and I hit anchor, what's going to happen is that as this boat drifts away from my anchor point, this unit's going to get really squirrely and start turning left and right and wrapping itself up, because it cannot resolve which direction it has to go to get back to this anchor point. Similarly, if I'm running a route and my points start heading down the channel, this unit is going to be acting very erratic. It might be wrapping itself. You know, it's not functioning properly, and it's very obvious that it's not functioning properly. And more often than not, that is caused by a calibration issue. So now that we've talked about how not to calibrate your ProNav Angler, let's talk quickly about how you should calibrate the ProNav Angler. And for this, I'll refer you guys to another one of our videos on YouTube. Check out ProNav Angler Calibration. You'll find our video talking about when to calibrate, how often, and why you should calibrate. The key points to remember when you're calibrating this unit for the first time or any time thereafter, make sure you have this unit situated 6 inches up the shaft above the turning steering box here on the motor. So that is a big magnetic source down here, the steering box. So we're going to move this unit up the shaft away from the bad magnetics in this steering motor. So it's situated 6 inches up, that's good. We're also going to make sure the boat is sitting in calm water to the extent possible. A little bit of rock is okay. You're not going to get the best quality calibration in a wavy situation, but you know, you've got to work with the conditions. So we're going to try to get the boat out of the wind, sitting in calm water. We're going to make sure that everybody's weight in the boat is such that the boat is sitting level. We don't want to calibrate with everybody hanging off one side of the boat where the boat has a big list. That's not how you're going to be when you're fishing typically. So we want to calibrate it in calm water with a level boat. And we want to get this motor and this boat at least a boat length away from anything like this dock, which has steel all the way through it. Out here we've got some steel pilings closely along the shoreline. We've got a bunch of cement slabs with steel rebar. So these are the types of things that you want to avoid contact with when you're calibrating the ProNav Angler. If you're on a wooden dock, a composite dock, an aluminum dock, and there's no steel structure, that is absolutely not a problem. You can calibrate this unit next to any of those materials, but make sure you're not next to a big chunk of iron. Similarly, if you have a electric winch up in the front of your boat and you've got a big steel anchor sitting up here, that would be another type of example of something that could cause interference with the very sensitive compass in this unit that it uses to guide your boat. So that's how not to calibrate the ProNav, a few bullet points on how you should calibrate the ProNav. And as always, if you have questions, comments, or feedback, we really encourage you guys to contact us. Contact us by emailing support@pronavmarine.com and send us your questions, or if you're having issues with any of these features, let us know, and our team is here to help you get through this process as seamlessly as possible so that you can get out fishing. So with that said, I hope everybody has a great season. It's off to a beautiful start here, and we can't wait to wet a line. So I hope you guys do the same. Tight lines for now from ProNav Marine.